Hi, I'm Stella from CoverageBook. This is a walkthrough of how to use the tool. I'll show you how to go from the moment that your coverage lands right through to sharing a beautifully designed report with your stakeholders that includes metrics that you can be really proud of. Whether your campaign includes online articles, owned social posts, whether you have worked with social influencers or got print and broadcast hits, CoverageBook helps you make your reports fast. By the end of this video, you'll understand all of the metrics that we pull in, how to add your own proprietary metrics if you have them, how to customise and switch the design to suit the needs of your stakeholders, and if you need to track team and client performance against KPIs, I'm going to share some tips on how you can use the tool to do that and reduce some of the time that you're using in coverage trackers and on status updates. So let's get started. When you first log in, you'll see this screen. It's the All Books page, and this is the home for all of your reports. This is your collaborative workspace. So whether you're working with your client team, your agency, or on your own, this is the overview of all of the reports that are being created in your account. You can organize them into collections here too. So whether you and your team work by monthly coverage or by campaign, or by clients, this is where you can set up those labels and organize the view. Okay, let's get started with making a report. So we need to add in the links of your coverage to the report, and there are two options here. So if you prefer to add coverage to a report as and when it lands, it's a really good idea to set up the design of the report first. Then you and your team members can come back and drop the coverage in. Or if you like to collect every final piece until the end of your campaign and you have a list of your final pieces you want to report on, then you can do it this way. We have a refined list of coverage URLs, so we're going to choose that option today. You'll need to add your online coverage and then separately your offline coverage. And this is because for offline coverage, you'll need to upload a few files. And for online, we can automate absolutely everything. You simply just add in the URLs of your online coverage. And when I say coverage, that could include online articles. It could be owned social posts, influencer social posts. If you have the URLs, you pop them into this box and we get to work on everything else. Today's walkthrough is focusing on online coverage. Getting your coverage into the report is super easy. You literally grab the coverage links and paste them into the box. We can read almost any link. So even if you're grabbing the coverage straight from searching on Google results, or you might have just received your monitoring email and you are copying the hyperlink, just paste them straight in and we'll get to work. We know how important the order of your coverage is to report readers, especially when they're viewing big reports. So that's why we've introduced report sections. And if you have your coverage grouped already, add them in here. We will take the title and then we'll follow that group and section throughout your report. If you don't have any specific groupings for your coverage, don't worry, just add all of the coverage in and you can always create those sections later. In this example, we are splitting our report by media type. So we are adding all of our online articles and then we'll follow that up with the social coverage. As you add in your URLs, we start to pull in the magic. So for these articles, we are pulling in our full screenshots of your coverage. We go to get the publisher stats, we get article level metrics, we'll be looking at how it's shared, the social engagements of your coverage, and we also put in some great SEO PR metrics too. So whatever area of PR you work in, we'll have some metrics to help you prove the impact. Here we're looking at articles. So for all of your media relations work, we pull in the full page screenshot of how the article appears on site. If you manage to secure a spokesperson quote or a branded image, well done. Or if you just want to highlight another area of your coverage to really grab the attention of the report reader, you can zoom in here. Of course, they can click through to the full article, but it's always great to highlight those key mentions. You can add in any additional images too, just here. So you might have some supporting campaign images or another screenshot of the coverage, just add that here. We want to save you as much time as possible. So we also pull in details like the date that the article was published, and we also read the page to have a look at what the article header might have been. Of course, if you need to change any of that information, you can edit it. Now, on to the important bit, how we measure coverage. We pull in a number of metrics from credible sources because we want to give you as much confidence as possible with stakeholders. So we look at the publisher site level data, such as monthly visits. So we get the monthly visits of publishers from a really credible source called SimilarWeb. We did a lot of research into monthly traffic figures, and SimilarWeb was definitely the most accurate. We also look at how established and influential the site is. So we do that by looking at the domain authority score, and we use Moz, M-O-Z, for their domain authority score. Site level metrics really only provide context to your report readers. We know that most people really want to know exactly how your coverage performed. So we also look at a number of metrics on an article level. We estimate how many people might have seen your coverage in its lifetime. And we do that by looking at the publisher's monthly traffic, the size of the site, where your coverage was placed, and how much it's been shared or engaged with. This produces this number, which is the estimated coverage views. Using a different formula, we also look at the estimated views for social coverage, but I'll come back to that. Staying with articles for a moment, we also provide how many social engagements it's had, so whether it's been tweeted, liked, or shared on social platforms. Plus, if SEO or digital PR impact is important to you and your stakeholders, we also scan your coverage to see if you secured any links to your client or organisation website too. If you did, it's a brilliant indicator to SEO value. It also provides a really good gauge on whether people have taken action from your coverage and they may have clicked through. So it's a good metric to include. We pull slightly different metrics in for your social coverage, so I'm just going to go through those for you. Whether you are working with influencers or you want to include your own social posts in a report, you literally just add in the URLs from Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and we automatically provide many metrics. So we've got the live follower and engagement metrics. Just like media articles, we estimate how many people may see your social coverage in its lifetime. This is really useful when you're trying to keep your campaign numbers reliable and realistic, which is so important in PR now. For our social estimated view metric, we factor in the social platform usage, how many followers the profile gets, and the engagements. We also backed this up with some research from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. You might recognize it as MIT. They did some amazing research into social post views, and we backed our formula up with that. It's an industry first in social reporting, and we really hope it helps set a standard for honest and realistic PR measurement. All of the clip metrics are pulled into this quick view summary area. The good news is that this area is totally customizable. If your report reader loves data, you can keep all of these metric cards in there, and they can look at the data from publisher traffic stats right through to estimated views and even to the individual social profiles, followers, and metrics. If one metric is more important, you can also highlight those. So for example, you could highlight the average domain authority score or how many links that you achieved in your article. Equally, if SEO isn't an objective of yours, you can also hide those metric cards and reorder them just by dragging and dropping. Remember, if your stakeholder is short on time, it might be an idea to only show the real key metrics of the campaign and hide the rest. Also, if you have your own score or metrics, so whether you've pulled in metrics from another source or you have your own scoring system, you can add in your own tiles here too. Again, maybe you might want to push those to the top if they're the most important to the report reader. It's really good to generally understand your report readers. So for example, if they are really data-led, add more metrics in, or if they're more of a visual person, you can just customise your report to match their needs. It just means your report is more likely to be read and shared, and that's what we want, right? Now on to customization. So you can add your organization or client logos in here. Again, we want to save you as much time as possible. So we look at the color of your logo and we can add that accent color throughout your report. Of course, if we don't get that quite right, you can change it. This is where you can add a title to your book. There's also space for a subtitle as well as the main header. And we also speed up the whole design process by creating a front cover for you. We take a look at all of your coverage and then we make a nice montage and add that in. Again, if this isn't part of your style, you can change it, you can upload your own image, or you can just remove the front cover and go straight into the report. If you've secured some standout pieces of coverage in this campaign that you're really proud of, you might want to highlight those right at the top of the report. We're going to highlight some of our social coverage in this example. So we've moved to the social coverage section and we are clicking on the star icon. As soon as the star turns gold, it will be added into the highlights section. I mentioned at the beginning of the walkthrough that you can organize your coverage into sections. This is where you can reorder and prioritize different sections, just like we're doing here. You can simply drag and drop or use the arrows. This is really useful when you're reporting on a big campaign, for example, a big end of year report that has many months or many sections to your report. Those individual sections can also be tailored to be on brand or to be highlighted in some way. So, for example, if you really want one section to stand out, you could add a lead image. So this could be a campaign image, or it could be a slide from a pitch document. You could keep everything consistent and add an image to every section. This is how you do that. Social post coverage can be a lot more visual than media relations coverage. So you have the option to switch the layout of sections too. For example, if you wanted to really show off the visual social posts, you can have the full posts on each page. Or, for example, if you got blanket coverage of the same media story and they went through lots of different regional sites and they all look really similar, you might not want your report reader to scroll through endless pages in a report. So, if that is the case, you could switch to a grid view or a list view. It just means that report reader can quickly have an overview of all of the metrics and all of the sites without having to go through many, many pages. You can see here that the coverage can also be quickly reordered, either by moving them into your own order that you choose, or you can use our sort feature, which will reorder by date or by metrics, such as audience or engagements. Again, it just means that you are drawing the reader's eyes to your best bits. If you know, for example, that your report readers only really care about the numbers, you can hide complete sections. So even though the visuals will be hidden, the total metrics will still be going into the summary. You can switch and hide that view here. At this point, it's a really good idea to take a look at the preview so you can get a view on the full presentation of the report and as the report reader will see it. Here you can see that we have the front cover, the logos, the on-brand colors, the summary metrics, any custom metrics that you may have added, highlights, and the coverage sections in the layout that you have selected. The report reader can click onto individual items at any point and see the full piece, and they can click through to the live coverage too. There is also a really handy content drop down at the top here to navigate the book. Again, this is super useful for those big reports or for stakeholders who just need to get to a particular section that's relevant for them. Once you're happy with the design, it's time to share the report. The online link is the best way to share a report. It can be easily pasted into emails or any online comms platforms that you use, such as Slack. The online link means that your report will always be up to date no matter when somebody's looking at it. So if your client might forward your report on to another stakeholder and they look at your report a few days later, they're going to have the most up-to-date metrics and share figures. Plus, if you get any last-minute pieces after you've shared the link, it means that the reader will always see the most up-to-date version. We know that reports can be shared with all sorts of people now outside of PR and marketing. We know that some reports are sent to financial directors or to CEOs. So if you know that you have a section in your report that is more relevant to your report reader, you can create a specific link to that section. So for example, if you are sending the report onto a sales team, you might want to highlight the section that looks at your product placement coverage first. You can customize the link to the section here. As well as a link to the report, you also have some options here to download all of your coverage screenshots. This is great if you have a presentation that you need to prepare. You can also get a PDF of the report if you need to print some high-res versions. And we offer a CSV file of all of the data. So this is super useful if you need to do any further measurement or analysis. You can see that we are downloading the CSV file here. And it pulls out all of the media titles, the dates, and every single metric. Some of our customers use the CSV files as a basis for their coverage trackers. However, if you use a coverage tracker, I have some handy tips on how you could use CoverageBook to save you some time. We have this all coverage section. This is every single clip that you have added to your account in one place. But you have multiple refine options here. So you can have a look at all of your coverage by date, or by metric, or by coverage type. You can get a really quick view of the coverage this week, this month, by client, by campaign, or you can take a look at all of the social coverage you got, or you can have a quick look at your biggest hits by audience view, for example. This is perfect for those last minute requests that you might get from a client, or when you need some quick examples for coverage for a pitch, or when you need to quickly create a quarterly report, for example. Plus, if you're an agency team lead or somebody managing agencies, this is a really handy view to keep track on performance against KPIs. So there you have a full view of CoverageBook. Enjoy creating your reports because we can't wait to show off your success.